It's not even about just the character of this president, but also his actions currently in office.
And so, Congresswoman, you were also at the center of this rather prolonged emotional exchange between you and Congressman Mark Meadows and Chairman Elijah Cummings after Mark Meadows had held up this woman who has worked for Donald Trump as what I believe you said was a prop. She didn't speak, and you felt that it was a racist act. So let me just play this moment.
Just to make a note, Mr. Chairman, just because someone has a person of color, a black person working for them, does not mean they aren't racist. And it is insensitive that some would even say it's the fact that someone would actually use a prop, a black woman, in this chamber, in this committee, is alone racist in itself. Donald Trump is setting
Mr.
the president.
Mr. Chairman, I ask that her words
Donald
be
Trump
taken
is setting
down.
The president. I reclaim my time.
Mr.
Donald
Chairman,
Trump is setting a president.
Mr. Chairman,
that the highest office can be attained.
Mr. Chairman, the rules are clear.
Activity. Cover up and hold on to business assets to break campaign finance laws and constitutional clauses.
So how do you feel about all of that today? Do you still today believe that Congressman Mark Meadows engaged in a racist act?
I believe that moment, as a person of color, and not only myself, three other of my colleagues had mentioned how insensitive that act was. I think all of us, I mean, even folks at home, kind of gasped when that actually happened. I think if we want to talk about race in this country, that was not the way to do it.
I'm being told that Lynn Patton, the woman who was held up by Mark Meadows without speaking then, has just spoken on a morning show. So let's both listen to that.
Racist than being put up there as a quote unquote prop.
But she's speaking out about it. And I also can tell you from her Instagram yesterday, she says, let me see where I want to get into this. But rather than those on the House Oversight Committee who sadly placed more credence on the word of a self-confessed convicted perjurer than of a highly educated black woman who rose up the ranks of one of the most highly recognized global real estate companies, spoke before 25 million people at the Republican National Convention, and now successfully oversees the largest HUD program in the country, this is not the resume of a prop. What do you want to say to her?
Well, I want her to know that it was no disrespect to her at all. I think she should be commended for her extreme leadership, for her work in the HUD organization, the administration. But I think for many of us, if we want to talk about race in this country, want to talk about some of the actions by this president as a Muslim American in this country, I know what he said about Muslims. I have seen what he said about Latinos and African Americans. But even in closed doors and what I think Mr. Cohn was trying to express to all of us, that was not the way I think my colleagues should have been able to debate that issue, and rather not to even disagree with Mr. Cohen. I think there was a better way of doing that.
And so back to that point yesterday, which is that, as you point out, there were people at home that felt that that was tone deaf and insensitive of Congressman Mark Meadows. You certainly were not alone in that feeling. And so why did you feel the need to apologize to him?
You know, I just want folks to know this is probably the most diverse class. This is the largest incoming class since Watergate. And yeah, we look differently. And many of us didn't run to be first of anything. But I think we ran because we wanted Congress to not only look differently, but also speak differently and feel differently. And for me, again, as a person and the member of that committee, I did not feel that I should be silent about the fact that how that made me feel as an equal member to Mr. Meadows and many of my colleagues on the other side of the aisle. At that moment, it was important for me to speak truth to power. It was important for me to speak out against that action that I thought was very hurtful and very painful for many of us sitting in that committee room.
And so do you regret apologizing to Congressman Meadows?
Well, no, I apologize if it made him feel like I was calling him a racist. I was at that moment, you know, as a person, as a mother, this was a teachable moment. For me, I used that moment to say, just FYI, that was not the way to do it. And it was not at all calling Mr. Meadows a racist. I really, if I wanted to, everybody knows this, I'm pretty direct, I would have done that. But that's not what was my intention. It was my intention to educate, to share what I was feeling at that moment, just like when he was feeling at that moment of what his reaction was to the comments from Mr. Cohen. I'm really, you know, wanting you to focus to discuss race in this country in a way that can be really thoughtful and constructive, not in a way that's very dramatic and again, no disrespect to her, but just to having her stand there saying nothing and saying, look, he's not a racist. I was still taken aback, and still to this day, it was like, that was not the way to do it.
I mean, look, I think this is a teachable moment, and I think that we are all having these sensitive, you know, what used to